All right. Really no need to say anything. If you have the eyes to see, there's just one thing I'm going to say. Listen to what they're saying and read the street signs. That's all I need to say.
I don't know what the hell it was, but it hit my roof. Something hit the roof. I wasn't sure what it was. I came out, looked. There was nothing there.
I was walking into my kitchen area, and all of a sudden there was a boom that rattled the windows, just like a sonic boom.
People living near 17th Avenue and Chandler in Ahwatukee describing what they felt.
But sometimes big semis going by fast make that happen, but there was nothing out there.
12:45, I was talking to my husband, and I said, did you hear that? I said, something hit the roof. And as soon as I hung up with him, I came out and looked. There was nothing there.
The Arizona Geological Survey has about 15 seismometers across the state and says an earthquake wasn't recorded.
So if there was some shaking in the area, I suspect we should have picked it up.
But he says it doesn't discount that so many people felt something shake. Just may not have been a quake.
It only lasted maybe 5 seconds. If that.
It was quick. It was not long enough to make me think it was an earthquake. It was more of an air impact on the window or like a big bird hit the side of the house.
Strange shaking in a North Phoenix neighborhood has the people who live there worried. They've been trying for years to figure out what's going on, but they've never had an answer for what's causing spontaneous vibrations to ripple through their homes.
And the occurrence is not like anything anyone in the area has ever felt before. New at 6.
It's just a rumbling noise, like a vibration. Almost sounds like a jackhammer between houses.
This is what people who live near 35th Avenue and Pinnacle Peak Road have been living with for years.
I used to live right by here.
A vibration that affects the whole neighborhood. It hits at random times, and when it does hit, they say they can feel it through their body. Something that so far no one has been able to figure out. Kelly Jackson says after more than a decade of this strange occurrence, it's taking its toll on her home.
My house right here, this crack has come out since then. It's going all the way, you can see it's going all the way down. Oh, it's doing damage inside and out.
12. New at 10, a mystery in Mesa. At least one neighborhood worried the loud bangs they've been hearing for weeks. Maybe more than just fireworks and celebrations.
Somewhere between 7 and 8:30 is when things get interesting out here. Another one of those booms actually happening tonight. We saw it for ourselves. Take a look.
7 and 8:30, 15.5.
Now, no one seems to know what they are, where they're coming from, if they're even fireworks or not, but it's not about the noise or whether or not they're annoying. At this point, it's become a safety concern.
I'm not an expert on these things, but it sure was scary.
In this East Mesa neighborhood, word travels fast.
Everybody seems to be saying, I don't know where it's coming from. Nobody can solve it.
All's calm outside usually, but when the sun goes down, the blasts begin.
It was scary big. It was not your normal firework kind of boom or just a noise from a car or something. It was a lot louder and scary.
Amy Reed caught this flash of light in what sounded like an explosion on her home security camera last week. The boom shook her entire home.
I thought I would just see somebody's house had blown up. You know, I was expecting I'd see fire in the sky or the big plume of smoke.
It's not the noise itself she's worried about. It's what's causing it.
I was sitting here watching your news here about, it was about 7:50. All of a sudden I seen my curtain move on my back door. I felt this like